Well, we finally put winter behind us, hopefully, and now it's spring, and we're out here with Jan. Jan, what do we need to be doing in our garden today?
Well, we always say this every year at this time. This is a soil thermometer to make sure that your soil is warm enough to support the things that you're going to plant. Right today, the temperature outside of the soil is 30, and in my greenhouse it's 40. So with that in mind, what I did, I've got all the things I'm going to plant, some of them in the greenhouse and some of them outside. I wrote on each package, this is a tomato that I'm going to put in the greenhouse, and lovage, which is a celery tasting herb. Right. It needs to be 65 degrees before you put it out. Zinnia is 70 degrees. That means that if you're going to buy starts, you really want to wait until the weather warms up so that they get a good start and they don't just sit there in cold soil.
Because we're definitely not there yet.
We're not there yet. And then my other more cold-tolerant plants, I'm going to plant rutabagas this year, but I'm going to do it, obviously, in the garden, so I have to wait a little bit. Lettuce is 40-plus degrees, so 10 degrees more today I could put the lettuce in. Sugar pod peas are 40 degrees, salad greens 45. So if you have one of these, and they're not very expensive, a soil thermometer, you'll see on the package what the soil temperature should be for good germination and continued growth.
Okay, so that's all great tips on that.
We'll do. And the other thing, the angry thing, I bought a brand new bag of slug bait, and the mice in the greenhouse ate it empty. So if you have slug bait, keep it in a tight jar or tight container of some kind that you'd be able to not have them do this.
Because you don't want your rodents to get into that. They'll even get into your seed packets too.
Right. Oh, for sure. Grass seed, anything. Right. Yeah, for sure.
And then we always have to mention the lemon.
That's true. Well, the lemon survived the winter in the greenhouse. I did heat it periodically. It has some lemons on it that I'm going to pick, and it's starting now to flower again. So after I pick the lemons, I'll fertilize it, and then those blossoms will pop, and we'll get some more lemons.
And then you have a couple other tips for us, but we're going to head back out to the garden to go
right,
check on
okay.
the So we've talked about some of the inside things to do, but we're also now out in the garden, and there's a couple other tips that we could do while we're out in the garden.
Right. Well, this is something I did this year, and why I haven't done it before, I have no idea. But after the storm, the ice storm and snow and stuff, we just raked up and we took the big sticks out, but I used all the fir boughs and fir cones and everything to just make a mulch between the beds, and it'll be fine.
Right. Why not? It's just going to break down.
Absolutely, it will, and it will smother out the weeds that are there. And also, it's not an issue for people that worry about acidic soils from fir needles or whatever, because it isn't the raised bed, it's the path.
Right, right.
So, the other thing that I need to mention, just because I've had more than one question about it, and that is, last year I couldn't get this particular variety of tomato, or I couldn't get this particular variety of cucumber. And so this year I'm going to buy them early so I don't miss out. Well, if you buy them early and put them out early, you're going to lose them anyway.
Right.
So just maybe contact an independent garden center or to find out what they're carrying and when, and be able to kind of gauge it that way to know. One person was, it was an English cucumber and a specific cherry tomato. And so just be careful. I know we had shortages, but I think the nurseries are going to beef up a lot of stuff this year anyway. But just be careful not to put
Don't
it
be
up.
Too much in a rush. Just be aware
Absolutely.
Of what's
and
coming on.
So the cucumber plant per se can go out like mid-May. And not April, because
right.
you'll lose it for sure. The other thing we wanted to mention, we actually mentioned it in a segment before, but the damage was done from the ice and the snow. Know what your shrub is if you're going to prune it. Know if it blooms on first year or second year wood, so you know how hard you can prune it. And just take your time and watch for the new growth to come. So once that new growth starts, you can prune it, fertilize it, whatever you want to do, but if you don't know for sure what it blooms on, you're not going to want to cut it clear to the ground and realize you just took out all the flowers right. for this year.
Because gardening does take some patience.
It does. It does, for sure.
It doesn't happen overnight. So, Jam, it's always a pleasure to have all the tips of the month. And so, you know, for you, it gives you an idea of what to do in your garden this month. And so for more information on this, make sure you go to gardentime.tv. So, Jan, thank you.
You're welcome.